Thank you.
Hi. I'm here today with a group of students from Brooklyn College who are studying television and radio. Some of them are going to be television producers. What I'd like to know is, what can these future producers, what can you tell them about what they could do to make the life of a child actor easier and maybe less traumatic towards the adult stage?
Let me take this one. There's plenty. First, kid actors are not adults. They're children. They have all the needs that children have. They need secrets. They need silences. They need time off. They need recreation. They do not need a parent, however pushy, saying, oh, we got to get out of here at 4 because we got a plane to catch at 5:30 because we got to be in Chicago to sign autographs. That's what they don't need.
Jay North, in your situation, your guardians were your uncle and your aunt.
Right, Geraldo.
Is it not a fact that they were physically abusive to you, even on the set?
Yes, they were. And really, it was nobody really knew what was going on because they had told me not to say anything to anybody about that physical abuse.
What would they do? What would they do?
Physically strike me and spank me. My aunt would pull my hair and grab me and shake me and scream at me.
And the reason being?
And the reason being, Geraldo, was because that they wanted me to be a complete perfectionist. I had to do every take perfect, every take the way that they wanted it.
And smile for everybody.
And that's the thing. You know, it's funny. I used to, when I would run out of things to say to people, I would just smile. That's all I knew how to do because I spent my whole life talking to people, doing shows, going around the country, meeting people, and I had a lot of fun with my mother when she and I would travel across the country and do things because she made it fun for me. But it reached the point of where I had no identity as Jay North. I was Dennis the Menace. So it was like, you know, as I told you, on Friday nights, I would have this outlet. I would go out to these, my uncle would take me out to see all of these horror movies, and I just loved watching all of this gory, horrible stuff, because during the week, I had to be this nice, sweet, wonderful little boy who was kind and gentle and smiled. And I didn't feel that way inside. I was in a lot of pain, I was suffering, and nobody knew, nobody looked deep enough to see that pain and suffering that was going on behind me.
Did you really fantasize killing them?
Did he ever? Jay was on stage 7, we were on stage 1, and he would come over to his schoolroom where Shelley Fabre and I were, and he drew the most macabre pictures, beheadings, stabbings, and all the rest. I wish I'd kept them because it was so sick. We all commented about it. And then later, as our friendship deepened, and this is about, 3 years ago, these old fantasies had names attached, real people that Jay had on a list, and he has the means to do some violence and scared Jimmy Hawkins, the guy who was on Annie Oakley for many years, scared us to death. I'll never forget it when he was saying, you know, I need a motorhome.
I'll stop.
But it was amazing, and that's when we got Jay into.
But you know, the thing that was so scary for me was that at that age, I remember going to these horror films, and I would put the people, you know, that I hated on the soundstage. I would put them into the role of the victims on the screen, like in The Village of the Damned. You know, when those kids were making the grown-ups do these horrible things to themselves, I would imagine that's this person, that's that person who's tormenting me and making my life miserable. And I just, you know, the thing that I've done, Geraldo, I've been in therapy for the last, I was on your show like 1 year and 8 months ago. And I have come to the, you know, I have seen that I cannot reach back into my past anymore and waste my energy seeking revenge on people who are long gone. All the people that caused me torment in that show and in that situation are long gone. What I have to do now is look inside. Look at all the stuff that I accumulated over those years and release it and let it go.